King's Quest IV, The Perils of Rosella. So we already played through King's Quest 1 through 3 already. King's Quest 3, during the ending, it ended on kind of a cliffhanger of Prince Alexander returning to Daventry, saving his sister from the dragon. King and Queen are elated. They toss the hat at him, and then it's to be continued, essentially. So, this is a 1988 game on PC, just like the other ones, developed and published by Sierra Online. And here we are. So, Perils of Rosella. Pretty much the same, or similar box art to the earlier two games. Sure. So we got another unicorn. Hopefully not going to be another bridal puzzle. Because we know how that one went in two. Ugh. Our last run-in with a unicorn did not go well. So this says over 800,000 sold now. This said 500,000 in the first three, I think, games. So I guess they sold another 300,000 since that was released. Sure. All right. And then back of the box here. Be prepared for a spectacular adventure. Three times larger than any previous Sierra adventure. A landmark in computer gaming that transcends existing standards of computer graphics, sound, and animation. The three times larger thing, I'm not so sure about that. Maybe they mean in disc size? Because there's more art? But this game is not three times bigger than the other ones. I'm sorry. powerfully dramatic King's Quest IV invokes emotion like no other computer game. With a unique combination of lifelike animated personalities, beautiful landscapes, and soul-stirring music. So this game has actual music, and we'll get to that just before we start the game, but actual music in this one. Let's see. Sierra has recreated the universe of King's Quest, a world that one moment will pull at your heartstrings, the next moment place terror in your heart. I got terror in my heart all the time because Roberta Williams' game design. Yeesh. Uniting the best programmers, artists, and musicians in the business, Sierra has created a constantly evolving universe where landscapes change from day to night, characters roam freely, and dramatic music interludes tantalize your emotions in a complicated tale of faith and mistrust. Your quest begins with a full-length cartoon. A full-length cartoon. Get ready for that one. And proceeds to plunge you into a fantasy world of mystery, intrigue, and enough plot twists to confound even the most dedicated adventurer. Alright. Embark upon a perilous journey into the darkest corners of the King's Quest universe. No one but many successful quests must be completed to save the royal family from a tragic destiny, with a surprise introduction and an equally unexpected conclusion. Plot twists abound as you strive to discover the mysteries of a strange land, overcome its hostile inhabitants, and reveal the secrets hidden within. Roam the grounds at night and discover areas that remain hidden during daylight hours. Okay, so it sounds like there's a day-night cycle in this one. Interesting. I actually didn't know that. Travel swiftly as time is of the essence, and each moment brings a royal family closer to ruin. Okay. Alright, features. Over 3.0 megabytes of computer code. The largest computer game ever produced. 3 megabytes. Okay. Alright, well this is 1988, so... Alright. So that's like two floppy disks worth of computer code. I don't know if that counts the art and the other assets, but sure. 3 megabytes of code, a full-length cartoon, introduction to the game, which is approximately 10 minutes. We'll see if that's true or not on our timer. Complete day-night cycle. Okay, that's new. I didn't know about that. Several mini-quests to complete before the final quest can be finished. Well, that's... How is that a feature? Because that was in the first three games, too. So, sure. Many strange and unusual places await your arrival. So, right away, the art. This is on a completely different engine from the first three games. And you can see right away in this that this looks way better than the first three. Explore the countryside carefully. Some things happen only at night. Encounter characters from ancient folklore and legends. So this looks a whole lot like the witch cave from King's Quest II. And it looks like there's three witches there. Alright. So we got supports mouse, keyboard, and joystick. So there was no mouse support in King's Quest III. It was, you could use the joystick to move around, but it was mostly using the keyboard and typing. There are 40 minutes of original music composed and performed by William Goldstein. Fame television series, Hello Again, a Touchtone film. Switched On Classics, a top record album. Sure. And then there she is, the final boss of King's Quest, Roberta Williams. We're going to be seeing a lot of Roberta in this game, by the way. Roberta is in the game. So get ready for that. Roberta Williams, designer of the King's Quest series, has sold more games than any other authoress in computer entertainment history. She sure has. All right, and then, of course, the media that the game came on. So this is a four-disc game. These are 3.5-inch floppy disks. Or no. Yes, 3.5-inch. Came on four of them. King's Quest III came on three discs, I think. So, I don't know. They're talking a big game about how big their game is, but this is one, precisely one floppy disk bigger than King's Quest III was. So, I don't know about that. Okay. And then, if we pull up the thing. Alright, so we got the manual here for King's Quest IV. The Perils of Rosella. So, the King's Quest I was written and designed by Roberta, and then King's Quest II and III were designed by Roberta, but they were written by somebody else. I think it was Robin, I think, was her first name, I guess. But now we're back to the solo act of Roberta doing the writing and design. And there's no other writers credited in this. So I'm guessing not. So there's also a note in the manual here that because it's copy protected, it may be installed on a hard disk or in a directory. Immediately after booting King's Quest IV, you'll be asked to enter a word from the documentation. After typing it in, it'll finish loading. The version that I have is from the King's Quest collection, and it does not have copy protection. So if I boot the game and you don't see any, that's why, because the version I have doesn't have the copy protection built into it. All right. This is the legend of King's Quest. Once in a kingdom called Daventry, there lived a king named Edward. Daventry is a very old kingdom, shared kings, both good and bad, over thousands of years. King Edward is a very good king, was also very old, and without children, disorder ruled. Yep, King Edward, generate further before he died, yep. So this is the story of King's Quest I, essentially. He sent for King Graham, sure. So this we're already familiar with. We played this already. So yeah, the three treasures, sure. The tails for the crown, yep. Magic mirror, yep. Light, so he's looking for Valenice, yep, that's, we already know that. Okay, mirror-wise, yep, mirror-clouded. So yep, that's Romancing the Throne. So this, the manual recaps the first three games, it looks like. Yeah, here's Mananin, stuff over there, so that's King's Quest III. Not gonna go over that because we already played that. Air is human. Alright, so according to legend, shortly after Rosella's rescue, King Graham decided it was time to pass on his adventurer's cap. Gathering in his wife and two children, the king offered a grateful smile upwards. Each family's member of his family gave him great pride. Gazing down on his children, he couldn't help but see the glint of spirited valor in their eyes. Knowing the future of his kingdom would rest soundly in the hands of his future heir, he slowly lifted his hands to display the infamous adventurer's cap, and now the commencement of the noblest adventure of them all. Sure. Alright. A Sierra 3D adventure game, simply stated, is an interactive movie. In this game, the main character is Princess Rosella, the daughter of King Graham. His main goal... Okay, so this is the goal, as stated by the manual, is we need to find... Oh, we need to find... Oh my god. One note, please, you're killing me here. One note, you're killing me here. Alright, I want to use the eraser tool. There we go. All right, we need to find the magic talisman to save Genesta, the good fairy. And then we also need the charmed fruit to save our father. Move swiftly in ingenuity. Because we have one day. Okay, we have one day to complete our quest, but apparently there's a day-night cycle in this game. So I'm not sure how that's supposed to work. Yeah, I have not played King's Quest 4. So prior to me doing these playthroughs, I had not played King's Quest 1, 2, 3, 4, or 8 before. The rest I played. Let's see. Okay. If you played an animated adventure before, this section can be skipped. Okay. Well, we're gonna skip that then. So yeah, it's the same tips as the previous one. Bring along some help. You may find it helpful to play along with a friend. Different people come up with different ways to interpret clues, and besides, most adventurers work in teams. Well, alright. I'll ask if I need help. Thanks. You don't have to have a walkthrough open next to me when I'm playing and then helpfully suggest things that just popped in your mind after you read the walkthrough. I can tell if you're doing that. Don't do that. Okay? Alright. Arm yourself with the proper verbs. Apparently bait is a verb, sure. Cure? Dim? Force? Frighten? Okay. So the verbs in this game are a lot varied. This one's gonna be, we're gonna use that one. Tempt? Sure. Gotta use this one. Shine, shake, say, save. Okay, so they're really... They went hard in the paints on verbs in this one. Okay. Restore. And then, of course, they have the... Hey, are you really stuck? Well, guess what? You can call our hint line. It's like $5 an hour, or $5 a minute. But, hey. They still got it. Okay, and then... they actually give you a little walkthrough. If you just want to get going in the game, they actually give you this. So I'm not going to read that because I want to go in blind. But they do actually give you a little walkthrough to start the game, and then that's it. It seems like the manuals are getting more and more threadbare the farther into these we get. All right, so. So an important change here for King's Quest 4. So previously up until this point, the King's Quest games that we played have been from the mid to late 80s, and they used the PC speaker. So it was like beep, 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 beep. That was the music in the game. But since this is a 1988 game, it is one of the first Sierra games to use a device called... the Roland MT32. So here it is. There are MIDI connections on the back of it that actually go into my computer down here. It's this card right there on the right. So there's my proper Sound Blaster card right there. And then over here is a dedicated PCI card for MIDI. And this sends signals up to this that get interpreted and turned into sound, and then there's audio out from there. So say in 1988, instead of having to listen to just PC speaker, you would also have a device like this in addition to everything else. And this would be your dedicated music player for your computer. So this is a later model of something like that. This is a Roland SC55, but we won't be using that just yet. So this is going to be the MT32. And you can see on the front here, there's an LCD screen. There's buttons on the side of it, which for the most part are not used. The round thing on the right is a volume knob, and that's another thing we won't be touching because it'll manually be setting volume for us. So I actually set up a camera so that you can see what's going on the LCD screen on the old Roland, because it does some neat things. It does some neat things. And that's half the fun, is being able to see that. So another thing I could have done for this is used a Roland MT32 emulator, which will emulate the audio that it produces. But I don't like emulating stuff, so we're using the real deal hardware. Okay. All right. So let's do it. So first I'll give an example of what the game sounds like in the old way. So PC speaker. So we're on King's Quest 4. And then need this. Okay, King's Quest 4. So you usually use an installer program to set which sound thing you did, but this is patched, so the installer program doesn't work for me. So what I have it set to now is the standard driver, which is just the PC speaker. So I'll give you an idea of what that sounds like. So for like 99% of people who played this game in 1988, this would have been their experience with the game. It would be these really great graphics and then PC speaker. So it was very rare for people to have an MT32 back at this time. So it was really neat that they actually put in support for it in this game. So, let's back out here, and then let's go into resource.config and change this to the magic word, which is mt32.drv. So, it's going to sound a little bit better. Oh, and also, I forgot. I forgot an important thing here. So, very important thing. Roland Cam. So, right here you can see it says "Thanks for playing" on here. So this is what the readout looks like on the MT32 screen. So, take a look at this as it's loading the game. Sierra presents. So yeah, this is quite an upgrade from PC speaker. And you can actually see it producing the sound. So it's got five instruments it can do, and then also R, which is the rhythm. So for whatever reason, it sets the volume at 36%, and it does that automatically. So, sure. All right, return of his long-lost son, Alexander, the rescue of the daughter of Zella from the terrible dragon. Old King Graham decides it's time to pass on his adventurer's hat to younger blood. He flings the battered hat toward his children, while his wife, Queen Valenice, proudly looks on. So yeah, the graphics... immediately looks so much better than 1 through 3. There's more pixels in just the characters than there were in the whole thing. Suddenly, there's a Grahamgasm. Alright, but King Graham having a bad time. I think I can turn up the MT here. What up? 76. Alright. Are y'all paying attention to this cartoon here? There's gonna be a quiz later. Who are you, she queries. Well written, Roberta. Who says queries? King's Quest III writer wouldn't have written that. That's true, LCC. That's true. Ah, how convenient. With her magic, she can bring her there. So there's trouble in Tamir, but she won't tell us what the trouble is unless we commit to killing over. Great. Uh-oh, Mir's breaking up. Oh man, she's guilt tripping us into getting on the plane, huh? All right. Does Rosella have purple eyebrows? Oh, that's her. Okay, that's her eyeshadow. Look through the woods. The evil fairy caught her unawares and stole the talisman. She will die in 24 hours. Okay, well, it looks like there is a day-to-night cycle, and that's it. Because it's GG if there's anything more than that. Thank you. Oh, well. More importantly, we can't go home without it, so. So whatever, man. Everything else doesn't matter. Alright. Nice choice of words there with Roberta. The tiny tree. Where can we find the magic fruit? A tiny island in a vast swamp on the other side of the mountains. Okay. East. All right. The Lutz Castle overlooks from the east. Disguises as a peasant girl. Okay. All right. Rosella. All right, we're 8 minutes into the ten minute cartoon. I have a feeling the cartoon is over. It also looks like I need to hit enter here. Yep. Okay. So the the 10 minute cartoon was actually 8 minutes. Nice. Well, I started the game or I started the timer right at the very beginning. So I don't know. Okay, does this turn up the MT? So this should go up when I change this. No? Interesting. So in a lot of occasions, the changing this also changes the MT volume, because it can send MIDI commands, but... Yeah, interesting. It's not changing it. Hmm. Weird. Okay. So it looks like, let's see if this blows up here. It doesn't. Okay, so there's a change right away. So the first three games would burst into flames if you tried to save in the where the game actually is, but here they can do proper directories in this one. And it also appears that music doesn't play all the time in this. So sure. I don't know how long or how often music's actually going to play. Okay, so we're at the start. We are at a... It'll let me draw here. We are at a beach. There we go. Beach. Oh, it still says 2 out of 4? Interesting. Weird, it shouldn't, but whatever, don't worry about it. I'll fix that bug later. Thank you for telling me though. Alright, so river coming from the east spills in the blue ocean before you, lonely beach. Okay, lovely meadow. Stretches eastward. Interesting. Well, first off, my handwriting isn't amazing to begin with, and I'm also writing on a Surface Pro, so it's like it ain't easy. But it's not like my handwriting is amazing regardless. So we got beach here. And then there's like a river. So there's the ocean and beach. Okay. Oh crap. Got to turn off numlock. Okay, so let's head north and see what's here. So if it's anything like King's Quest 1, 2, and 3, it will wrap around at some point. And it looks like there's a little bit of a... Looks like that. There's my amazing artist interpretation of what this screen looks like. Okay. What about the rocks? So are the... There are not many rocks around here, except for this enormous one right here. Oh. Roberta says, next time, be more careful. God damn. So, Roberta's in the game. She is disappointed with you in the death screens. Oh, boy. Okay. So, let's stay away from that thing there. All right, now can we... Oh, yeah. What about the rock? There is a rock right there. Okay, so we got... What we got here? See, very few trees. There's a tree right there. So, oh, man. Okay. All right, and actually, before we go any further, I need to Alt-Tab, and I need to disable the... Well, first we have to hear this. Perfect. I need to go into the sound controls, and... Okay, so the buzzing isn't from that. Never mind. Carry on. Okay. So this is this screen. So we got more beach here. Okay. We also have a tree, but it doesn't seem like the tree is gonna be of use for anything. Okay. So we got a house, a pier. We got a little bit more water here, and then we have house, and here, sure, fisherman's shack. Okay, it's a shack, not a house. Okay, old pier looks out into the ocean. Let's see if anybody's inside. Just open the door. Don't need to knock. Wait, hold on. That made a sound. Okay. All right. Talk to woman. What are you doing here, young lady? Can't you see I'm busy? We have enough problems without worrying about you. Okay. Can we steal any of their stuff? Get kettle. Look, stove. Take stove. Dang it. So what's this over here? So there is mouse support, and you can use that to like click to move around, but it's not doing a whole lot. Because, like, in Space Quest 3, which is in the same engine as this, you could, like, mouse over things and right-click it, and it would look at whatever you right-clicked, but does not do that in this. Okay, can we get Can? You won't. Well, geez. Is that a key or rope? Look, rope. Look, key. We don't have any key. Okay. Can we take their fish? Dang it. Okay. Won't be bad. Yep. Okay. All right. Not much doing here. Sure. Aperture. Much to do in every scene? Not really. Not really. There's an anchor. Can we take their anchor? Too heavy. Okay. That explains that. I was just about to say, there's not a whole lot of music in this game, but here's some. And it seemed like the music stopped when I was typing. Oh. Oh, shit. Okay, well. Good thing she can swim. This jackass fisherman pushing us in the water. Dr. the Grizzle Fisherman... Them fish ain't been biting lately. If things don't get better soon, I don't know what to do. Try to talk pleasantly, fall on deaf ears. Obviously annoyed by our presence. Okay. Well, not sure what the hell we can do there. Okay, and then, so the screen next to this is pier. With more ocean. Can we take bird? Can't catch it. Okay. Okay, maybe you're not supposed to catch the seagull. All right, look. What's with the barrel? Nothing of interest. Okay. So not a whole lot doing on this screen, I guess. Okay. I guess we'll keep heading north along the beach and see if it wraps north and south. I suspect it will. Yeah, like the other MT32 games, they do have music throughout the whole game. So it is unusual that this game only has music at certain parts of the game and not throughout the whole thing. Because the other MT32 games do not behave like that. Okay. So not a whole lot here either. And this is the screen we started with. Okay. Okay, so it looks like the game wraps around north and south. So we're right here. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's 5 screens, north and south, it looks like, that it wraps around. We'll just say that. This. Okay. And that works out because I can't scroll up any further in my notes. Okay. So what is over here? Look like a tank. What, this? That? Or something else. Okay, so we got a little river thing. Hang up like that. Oh, last screen down. Let's see. Oh yeah, that thing. Yeah, that right there. Yeah, I could see that. I could see that. If that looks like a tank, sure. All right. So let's head north from here. And we got flower and tree. We got a whole lot of nothing. So meadowland with wildflowers. So this might be a screen where there's like random encounters. This certainly looks like a random encounter screen. Minstrel, okay. Sure. Say hello. Well, what do we have here? Hello, Rosella. Let me play for you one of my favorite tunes, an old ballad. Unfortunately, it appears that his musical skills are quite limited. Plunks and pings his way through otherwise beautiful song. Sure. Can we take his loot? Not gonna give you, his soul means livelihood. Okay. Ask for loot. It's not an okay. Another bad rendition. Tighten up the graphics. Yeah, that's King's Quest 1 is what, 84? And this is 88. And this is also on a different engine. This is what's called the so this build is August 7th, 1989. This is on the SCI Sierra engine, and the first three games were on the AGI engine. So this is like a generational shift in how these games are made. Out of tune, green sleeves, all right. Right, I'm gonna crank up the MT here. It keeps setting it to 50. Another popular ballad. There you go, Olimar. It's not in front of the game players. All right. Okay, fantastic. So another big difference here from King's Quest 3 is that in King's Quest 1, 2, and 3, there was the parser on the bottom of the screen, and you could type in, and you could also keep moving. In starting from 4 onwards, if you're moving and you start typing something, the on-screen action will pause while you're typing in your command. So you don't have to be as quick or as accurate anymore. You can take your time if you're putting in commands, starting this one, and I think that's generally for the better. It makes it slightly easier to play than the first few, but I generally like this system a little bit better. All right. So there's more flowers. There's flowers everywhere. Jeez. Yep, play the loot badly. Yeah. I'm really hoping there would be more music in this. But hey, it's a start. It's new technology. Because I'm pretty sure this is the first game that they made that had MC32 support. Okay, so this is just save flowers. Okay. So this should wrap around to the north again. So we'll head screen east and continue our mapping. Okay, so this is the pool, sure, and there's Cupid, I guess. So Cupid putting down the arrows and then going for a bird bath, as you do. Talk to Cupid. Cupid doesn't seem to hear us. All right, what if we get in the pool with Cupid? What's up, Cupid? Dang it. Oh, steps at the north end. Sure. Well, how the hell did... Oh, geez. Okay, so this was to the north of the pool. Yes, it does, Aperture. Here, I'll demonstrate that. Let's see. I showed this at the very start of the game, but it is worth showing again. So if you go into the, there it is, resource. So in the setup here, you can see the different drivers that it uses. And normally this is changed through the installation program at the start, but say if we go back to STD standard, then this is how the game would have been for 99.9% of people who played the game back in the day. So if we go back to the minstrel screen and then we talk to man. So you can see it's much different, right? So going from this to the MT32, just night and day difference. But the MT32 was super expensive back in the day. Like, just your regular ass computer parts were expensive, but the MT32 was especially expensive because it was made for digital musicians and music production, more so than like as something you'd walk into a computer store and buy off the shelf. Like the MT32 was like a special order type deal. And you also needed a another add-on card in order to properly use it, which is why I use something called the hard MPU to interface with it. Because you can't just hook it straight up into a sound card. No, no, no. That would be too easy. I gotta turn up MT again. It keeps setting it down to 36. Okay. Luckily, this is only a problem with the volume thing for this game. It's not a problem with the other ones. Okay, so the unicorn was down here. So this was corn. Okay. It set the volume back to 36. God damn it. shies at your approach and trots away. Okay. Well, we found the unicorn at least. And we need Cupid to come back. Oh. Uh-oh, we startled Cupid. All right. Of course, we fall in the pool again. All right, Cupid left its bow here. So we're going to permanently borrow Cupid's bow. Okay. So you can't... Okay, so you can look at items, but it's not... God, I gotta turn this up. Come on, MT, you can do it. There you go. So it used to give a text description of the items, but now it just shows them. So, sure. And there's two arrows? Well, hey, it wouldn't be a King's Quest game unless we were stealing people's stuff, right? Okay, so let's head south of here. Oh, god damn it. Yep, Cupid is Cupid. Okay. And yeah, as far as like specialty MIDI equipment goes, I also have, might as well bring this up here too. I also have. So here's the MT32. I also have a Roland SC55. We'll be using that for later King's Quest games. I also have an SC88 and an XV5080, but I will not be using those. So, but yeah, that's what that looks like. Okay. Okay, so back south. Okay, so there's the crow with the glowy eyes looks a little suspicious. Okay, and it's a raven and it's not friendly. Okay, so this is, let's call this forest, because this is a little bit more heavily wooded. So that crow is keeping tabs on us, I guess. So here we have another rock surrounded by flowers. Okay, so this large rock in particular is noteworthy, apparently, unlike all the other ones. There's also this green bird just vibing up here at the top of the screen. I don't know what was that bird up to. Small birds here and there. Okay, so apparently that bird, whatever it's doing, it's of no concern to us. Okay. So this is pond with tree. And it's got music, but I'm not sure why. Water lilies. Oh, a large frog. Okay, frog wearing a little girl crown. Okay. Ah, there it is. It's kind of blending in, but frog with crown is over there. Okay. I just realized I have a pointer here, and I can just do this, but it'll be too easy. Oops, you scared the frog. Oh, god damn it. Rosella, please. Talk to frog. Ribbit, ribbit. What else did you expect? Well, kiss frog. First need to get the frog. Too far away from it. How the hell are we supposed to do this? Okay. We need to bait the frog, I guess, somehow. Huh. Okay. Sure. Though, come to think of it, the frog and the prince frog thing, if it's anything like the Fable, we need a gold ball, I think. And we have to drop our gold ball in there, and then the frog gets it for us, and then we kiss him. So I'm guessing that's probably what we need. We need some sort of thing to... Because I don't think we can just... Yeah, we don't have it, so we can't bait the frog. Sure. All right, so the screen to the south of us we've not been to yet. And maybe this is where our golden ball is, because that looks gold. It's got 3 gold pixels and a red pixel. So this is... This is a bridge. And I'm guessing it's got the gold ball. Probably. It's probably got the gold ball. Look under bridge. Ah, small golden ball. Okay, just like I thought. All right, so we can use that to solve our frog problem. So if we drop ball in, well, let's look at it first, sure. Look. Ball. Okay, the gold ball looks like a gold ball. Who'd have thought? Drop ball in pond. You accidentally drop the golden ball into the pond from the top of the lily pad. The large green frog leaps into the water and disappears. Moment later, frog emerges with, yes, your lost ball in its mouth. Seems as if the frog is kindly returning your gold ball to you. Sure. So why did it describe all that when it's just going to show us what it did later? Nope. All right, thanks, frog. Kiss frog. Get frog. Okay. It's frog. Hold it in your mouth. Hold it in your hand. Sorry. Stares at you. Wobbles its throat. Can we look at the frog? All right. So we have the frog. And we. It looks like a frog. Sure. Kiss frog. Good. You feel silly doing this as you slowly put your mouth against the frog's. A handsome prince. All right. Who are you? I thought you were supposed to be a princess. Why, you're nothing more than a peasant girl. All right. Well, ta-ta, I'm off. Here, you may keep this. Toss a little golden crown to you. Good riddance. So again, it's the tell and then the show in this, which I think that's bizarre that they did that. Okay, we got the ball back. Inventory cannot be displayed this time. Why? What? Sure. Got crown. Okay. All right, so that covers everything but the unicorn screen. I'm not sure what we're supposed to do in the unicorn screen, though, but whatever. Whatever. All right, let's keep heading east. So this is a cemetery. Run down gloomy cemetery, gives you the creeps. Maybe the old tombstones have fallen over. Entire place is overgrown. Okay, so this probably has something to do with that day-night cycle. As I bet coming here at night is probably going to be spooky. Cemetery. Okay. Can we take this cross that's here? Get cross. Can't get that. Okay. What about that hole in the tree? Okay. Nothing doing there. Yep, Roberta worked hard on this story. This is original story. Do not steal. Roberta invented all of these fables. So what the hell is this? This is like... Rustic water wheel. There's a water wheel? Oh, there is. Okay. So this is like, this is a treehouse. Okay. Can I go in this water without dying horribly? Oh, just realized I wasn't clicked into. There we go. Okay, let's see what's inside here. There's clearly a fire in the fireplace, so. Oh. Okay, just unattended fire in the fireplace. This is the main room of the Seven Dwarfs Cozy Treehouse. Okay. Original story, do not steal. What a mess. Okay. Nothing in the cupboards. Look. Pot. Pot of soup. Okay. Oh, man. This looks just like home. Small upstairs bedroom, seven dwarfs. My goodness, these dwarves are sloppy. All right. Well, can we clean? Okay. We can clean. Minutes of dwarves entering the house. Only four more to go. Look, they had a long day at work. All they want to do is add some extra flavor to the stew, one by one, and then take a bowl. Must be really hungry. Very pleased that we tired of it. That's your name. Uh-oh. We're invited to eat the soup. Is this game over? Don't do it, Rosella. You can't get married now. King's Quest VII never happened now. Dang. And they all just eat in silence. Well, oh, time for the little men to go back to the mine. Okay, one by one. See you in 10 minutes. Left a something there. The best soup you've ever tasted. You were just really hungry. Yep. Sure. Alright, can we clean this? There's still that blue thing on the table. Okay. What is this on the table? Long wooden table. What? That, okay, blue pouch. Got it. Alright, that's a lot of points. Inventory cannot be displayed at this time. Why? What? Why can't I look at my inventory? Okay. Pouch. Diamond pouch. Okay, it's full of diamonds. Alright. They probably want that back. Okay. Well, that's probably all we can do here, I'm guessing. Alright, so we've already been north of here. That was a cemetery, so let's head south. I can through this. Yep, okay. Alright, we got a little hill with a door. So this is hill with door. Let's see what's in here. Oh, it's a mine shaft. Okay. Say that this is the mine. And that's probably where the doors went, I'm guessing. Okay. Diamonds glitter and sparkle. The diamond mine. Okay. And they probably want their pouch back. Give pouch. Give diamonds. Do they not want it back? Oh, jeez. Okay. Talk to Orf. Too busy. Well, this one's just kind of standing here. Just looking at him. Pretty sure he's not busy. Okay. Say hello to the small man. Rosella! How does he know our name is Rosella? We never told him. Okay. Give pouch. We offer the forgotten pouch store. So now you keep it. We got plenty here. We also got an extra lantern. Okay. Now skedaddle. Okay. All right. Score. We got free diamonds and free lantern. Which... Okay, now we can see our inventory. Lantern unlit. Sure. Okay. Got lantern. Okay. I like this theme. This is probably one of the better. Oh, jeez. Come on, Rosilla. She's tripping. This is also probably one of those instances where using the mouse to move around would be a little bit easier. Okay, so. Alright, we haven't been south. There's still the two screens at the north end that we have. Okay. Okay. So just like King's Quest 1 and 2, you can cheese encounters. So this is, that looked like a giant to me. And there's a house here. Large thatched house surrounded by forests, very formidable. It might be wise to use caution here. Okay. That is a enormous door. Okay. It's locked and you don't have the key. Okay. Makes you feel uneasy. Okay. All right. Let's head south then. Okay, we got pine cone. Oh shit. Oh, oh, oh. Oh no. Roberta's gonna be quite upset with us. Oh man. Let Roberta down again. Oh shit. Alright, I gotta save when we leave this screen. It set the volume back to 36 again. Just MT32, you're killing me here. I could just crank up the gain on it in my my capture stuff, but then if it does suddenly get loud, then it's gonna blow out ears. So I'd rather not do that if I didn't have to. Okay, so giant house, and then the screen south of giant house was pine cones, I guess. I'm just going to write down pine cones. Like maybe there's a use for pine cones at some point. Okay, so that means that we've gotten all of that mapped out already. So let's keep heading east. Oh, nope. Don't want to go there. Okay. So east of the mine is just trees. Dense forest, according to this. Okay. So is this any different if I leave the screen and come back? Okay, there's a bird in the lower right. And I only know about this because I get worm. Okay, so we got the worm. I only knew about that because I tested the game earlier and I got to this screen and I saw the bird there. Like, if I didn't test the game, I wouldn't have known that was there. So great. It seems like all the empty screens could possibly have plot things. Fantastic. Okay, so what's to the south here? Okay, those trees look... This is a creepy place, grove of very old trees. Thick forest. So this is... Huh. So let's say... Creepy trees. Okay. Where even are we? Okay. So this is probably going to end in Rippin' Pepperonis, but what happens if we walk through this totally not creepy forest. Okay, well, if we get close to this tree. Ah, these trees can't talk. Okay. So, off-screen tree got us? All right. Thanks, Roberta. Thanks, Roberta. Okay. So we need to... Oh, God. We got to go get the worm again. Okay. Go. Okay, so Creepy Trees was to the south of us, so... So if we go north, what does that get us? Okay. Walking through the forest, thick with pine trees, nearby river rushes westward from the distant mountain range. Distance. Okay. So here we got kind of this river cutting through it a little bit. I'm guessing I can safely walk through that that river there. Nothing special, okay. Cold water rushes westward. It doesn't say anything about it being dangerous, so probably okay to cross it. Okay, good. All right, let's head north. Huh. Spooky old house. No one's lived here for many years. Rundown cemetery on both sides. Okay. This is... Oops. So this is spooky house. And apparently there's a cemetery on both sides, so... We can go ahead and pencil that one in. Okay, let's see if we can go inside Spooky House. Okay. This looks like the Hugo's House of Horrors house. Enter a mold house downstairs. You see two open doorways upstairs, additional to cobweb, dusted wallpaper. Okay. Look at that amazing reflection. Okay, can we get glass from the mirror? Can't get that, okay. Okay. So there's no in-game clock in this, like in 3. So apparently there's supposed to be a day-night transition at some point, but I don't know when that's supposed to happen. Maybe it's triggered by a cutscene or something. Okay. Old dining room, seen better days. Empty hutch. I guess this is a hutch. I've never heard that expression before, but okay. Can't do that now. What? Why not? Sure. Okay, what's this on the table? What are the crumbs? Okay, can we get some crumbs? You have no use for crumbs. Well, what if Roberta Williams wanted to totally think up herself the Hansel and Gretel story? Looks like there's more crumbs here. You see more crumbs. Yeah, can I get these crumbs? You have no use for crumbs. What? Huh. So what is this? This is another butter churn. Okay. The thing in the back corner is clearly fireplace coal, dusty pantry. Yeah, it's just crumbs. Like, what the hell is this? Is this like the fire poker or something? Can we get the candle? Can't get that. Nope. Get pot. A candle would have been good, but... okay. Well, I don't see anything too useful in here. All right. Is that Roberta up there? So this room's in decent condition. Her eyes seem to stare at the left wall of the parlor. Okay. Notice a latch. Okay. Use latch. Open latch. Look latch. You could try flipping. Flip latch. You flip the latch. Secret door, okay. No points for that, apparently. Alright, so just like... I'm right next to it. Roberta. Okay. So yeah, this looks like another staircase that we could... We can fall down. So let's see. Let's see falling from this height wall. Oh, she just jumped? Man. Roberta's got ups. That's not Roberta, that's Rosella. Alright. Okay. Alright, well that is too high apparently. Alright. One stair too many. Yep, Rosella can dunk from the free throw line. Oh god, this is fantastic. Wait, you have to press up. You have to press up to go up the stairs. You have to press up to... What? Sure. Okay. You're not... Oh. Sit. God. Roberta. Play that organ. Actually looking at my input for this, it's already turned up all the way. Okay, so I don't know what that did, but we sure played that organ. Okay, now we gotta try not... Alright. So anything else of note up here? Just a dusty old pipe organ, okay. I'm not sure what this is over here, but... Okay, good thing I made that mute button. Alright, back down that dumbass staircase. Okay, so hitting down makes you... Okay, now it switches to the way it should be. Okay, whoop. Yeah, it was probably just holes. All right, time save strats. You jump off the staircase. Okay, so that's... any... examine the books. None of the books are up to the quality of reading. Okay, sure. About fireplace. Okay. Nothing of interest. Okay. It's all this stuff. Okay, so nothing of use there. Okay. What in the hell happened here? Did the bed melt? Old bedroom, cheery fire, occupant. What? So the bed melted, and then what happened here? See, nothing special. Okay. Can we open it up at least? Open dresser? Just a drawers, okay. What about the thing over the fireplace? Okay. So can't do anything with that. Then this is the last, looking the last room. Drawers are empty. Okay. Master bedroom, dust covers it. Okay. Sure. Drawers are empty. Okay. Man, not a whole lot in this house. All right. Can we ride the horse? Too big. Dang it, Roberta. Old rocking horse. Yeah, this is a much more modern game. Modern engine. Baby nursery, cherry place, neglect cobwebs, wallpaper, dust covers the nursery furniture. Okay. Look in crib. Do I even want to know what's in here? Oh, okay. Can we sit in the chair? Waste your precious time. Well, geez. Well, geez, Roberta. Okay. So I have a feeling whatever needs to be done here, it probably needs to be done at night. So probably not too much to do here. Hey, Minami. And yeah, not only does the game look a lot better than the other ones, this game also has a proper sound card. Well, not quite sound card. External MIDI device support. So we'll just save here. And yeah, here's an example. Oh, okay, never mind. Here's an example of the MT32 MIDI device, and you can actually see it making the sound up here. So no more PC beeper. We got proper audio support. Okay, so so that was that. So that is that spooky house. So we already looked through spooky house. We saw nearly everything. Let's go to the screen to the north of us, so we can know at least what's there. Yep, proper beepers. So this, the MT32 predates like the... oh, this is more creepy forest. Okay. The MT32 predates something like the Sound Blaster, because something like the sound card with the Sound Blaster would have been more common, but those came out later. So this, the MT32 would have been a very rare, but one of the earlier ways to get proper music in oldish PC games. All right, so let's head south and then go to the cemetery screen to the east here, which is apparently a cemetery according to the in-game description. And see if there actually is a cemetery there. And yeah, we I'm assuming you missed the first bit of the stream where we played through the beginning of Codelca. And Codelca is very good so far. I'm really enjoying Codelca. We're on disc 2 of Codelca and about 3-ish hours in. All right, scary old cemetery, tombstones crumbling, mountain range. So there, it looks like there's a crypt on the right part of the screen here. I'm going to make a note of that. Okay. Ah, crypt door built in the mountainside. Good. Good thing I noted that. Door's locked. Okay, so that's... Let me make a note of that. Locked. Okay. All right, so we haven't been anywhere north or south of here, so this is all new territory as far as this goes. And it looks like we might be near the end of the world here. So a mountain range looms to the east. So usually when it said that in the first three games, that meant you couldn't go any farther in that direction. So we might not be able to go any farther east of where we are, which is right here. Apparently the back of the box said that this is a way bigger game area than the first three games combined. And so far... If this is correct, this is actually smaller than the first three games combined by a lot. But when has Ken Williams ever lied to us? Oh God, there's more creepy trees. There's all kinds of creepy tree screens in this game. Creepy trees. Okay. There's something over here. That looks suspicious over there. Steep mountains block your way to the east. Okay. I have a feeling I can't go north from that screen. Okay, so what is here? So here is a... Here's more stream with a waterfall. And yeah, it's looking like this is very likely the eastern end of the game world here. The writing seems worse. Well. I think I know why. Hold up. So if the writing seems significantly worse in this game, Perhaps we can intuit why. I don't know. I don't know why it's way worse this time. It's a mystery. There's only one writer credit in this game. It's a mystery, though. It's a mystery. Who knows? Alright. Excellent waterfall. Tumbles into deep pool. Flows westward as a rushing river. Okay, so it says rushing river this time. So, in the first couple games, that implied that if you get in this water, it's GG. Hope you saved. So, let's do that and hope for the best. Okay, well, that's still fine. Okay, so you do actually get into a... You don't have to manually type in swim in this game. So there's exciting technology exclusive to King's Quest IV. You don't have to type swim anymore. Okay. So what is all this then? It looks like I can't go south from here. Interesting. So this is mountain path. Can't go through there. Okay, can we go south from here? So this should wrap around. Yeah, it doesn't let you go south from here. Interesting. Okay. So this is like the far. Okay, I need to get out a different marker for this. So this means that this is impassable. And I'm guessing that this is impassable too. And the cemetery, yeah, that was impassable. Creepy trees, I think that was also impassable there. But yeah, we still haven't seen the screen north of creepy trees. So it looks like here the set of three creepy tree screens is clearly guarding something. And whatever it is, it's there. So we have to get past those creepy trees somehow. But first, let's see what's to the right of the screen. I'm not sure how we're going to get past the creepy trees. I'm hoping it's not RNG. But can't. Roberta. You're killing me here. Why did you make this pixel perfect? Oh, Lolotz goons. Okay, so this is more path. And there's a castle in the distance. Interesting. Hey, Cerberus. Welcome. Yep, you caught the stream. It's not going to be going on for that much longer. So, you caught the end of it. We'll go for another, say, half an hour or so. Okay. Yeah, this is probably still safer than walking up that path. Well, my pits, what have you drug home today? All right. So is Lolote and Adelmau. Are you a spy? That must be the amulet that we need, is the thing on her neck. Nothing but a poor peasant girl. Doesn't seem to believe you. Okay. First time you experience a real fear and begin to tremble. Okay. You don't look stupid enough to have wandered here. Alright. Take her to the cell. Why do I stream so late? This is when I'm usually up. Alright, do we still have our items? Sure. Found yourself in a horrible cell. His father is found there too. Alright. We take this whip. We might need it for something. Securely attached to the wall. Alright. Can we take skeleton? Can we take the rope? Get skeleton. All of this stuff in here looks like it might be useful. Can we get the skull? We could do something with this skull, maybe. Nope. Get bones. You'll have to take a different approach. What? Get bone. So this is a possibility, but... Huh. Perhaps they're setting me free. Yeah. Alright, well, we're locked in the dungeon for 30 seconds. A chance to prove our innocence, okay? The whole face just turns red, okay? I wish to own the unicorn. Okay, bring me the unicorn, set you free but reward you. Sure. Take it back to the forest. Okay, so what we got the pouch of diamonds. The unlit lantern. Gold ball, small crown, cupid's bow, shovel, and worm. Huh. Okay, so if we're gonna catch a unicorn. So we still haven't been to this screen up here, which I'm curious as to what's on that screen. And maybe I can get there if I go this way up into there, perhaps. I don't know. So the unicorn was down here. So unicorn was just a few screens to the left of here. So there's the giant's house. Yeah, geez. So anytime we got close to the unicorn, it just kind of walked away from us. Okay. Got quest to get unicorn. All right, so I'm curious if we can go north to the whatever's in the far northeast corner of the map here. That maybe there's a certain path we gotta walk, like here and then up. Okay, so that one clearly grabs ya. Okay, so I'll save on the spooky screen. Like maybe if we crawl through there or something. Yeah, precision walking is always the best part of these games. Creepy trees, dress again. So if I walk like right here, okay, we get grabbed. It didn't do that in the other creepy trees area. So if we walk like, okay, if we walk there, we get grabbed. So we got to go no further than that. Okay, but that was not working either. And then, like, okay. I still get the feeling this is possible. Just really, really difficult. And then if I go upper right from here. Okay, so that one's no good. And then, so we can't go any farther right. I'm hitting right and it's not letting me go right. And one more pixel up and to the right just gets you caught. So that's no good. So going left, and can we go up from here? Okay, we get caught there. All right, so that leads me to believe that this is a no-go from there. And I'm pretty... So here's where we tried to make it through there, and that didn't work. We already tried going through there. I'm pretty sure that didn't work either. So, maybe it's different during nighttime or something, but that looks like a no-go for now. Okay. So, dang. So my next question is... Is there going to be anything different on the screen as we go between the two screens? Yeah, I don't see any differences. If there's any difference, it would have shown up by now. Okay, so this is the screen east of the mine. To the west of here is the mine, and then to the west of the mine is where the unicorn spawns. So maybe the unicorn wants some diamonds? I guess. Maybe we need to... Sure, let's just save there. Okay. So that's where the unicorn is supposed to spawn. Or where we saw it last time. And... Is this GG because I already scared away the unicorn at the beginning of the game? Or maybe it's to the west of here? We haven't been west of here since coming this way. So it flew away to the east, I think, after we startled it. There's also the minstrel. Maybe we can trade the minstrel those diamonds for his loot. I don't know what that would accomplish, other than not having to listen to him play anymore. Oh. Okay, so this is also a unicorn's spawn. Maybe the unicorn likes loots. Alright, so its horn did a little sparkly thing and then it just left. Okay. Where's the minstrel? There he is. Trade for loot. Buy loot. Talk to man. All right. All right, give pouch. Politely declined. He declined a pouch full of diamonds. What? Talk about loot. All right, hold up. So let me look at that list of verbs again to see if I'm missing something here. So according to Roberta, There's a whole bunch more verbs that we can do in this game. Okay. So dismount, bait, low bounce, break, bridle. Okay, there's a dedicated bridle one. Catch, command, cross. Maybe if we dance for him? We already tried undressing, and it didn't do anything. So we can try kissing him. We can dance. That is not clear. Dance for man. Dance. That is not... Okay. All right. Get you more trouble than... Yep, short. Yeah, believe I've been strong. That is not clear. Let's see. There's frighten. Frighten is one. Frighten man. Yo, what? Hold up. Roberta. Frighten. This game does not understand frighten. Did I spell it right? F-R-I-G-H-T-E-N. What the fuck, Roberta? help? Hide, give, go. Hit, hug, jump, kill, kiss. White, lock, look, move, open, pet. Play, polish. Pry. What? Shine, shoot, shout. Okay. Well, all right. What if we make him fall in love with us by shooting him with shoot man with arrow? You can't do that now. Use bow. What do you want to do with Cupid's bow? Use bow on man. Okay. What if we shoot the unicorn with the bow? It just occurred to me. If we can ever get it to spawn again. Because that'll probably make it not want to run away from us, right? If we can ever find the unicorn again. this one. So this is the stream. So north of here was the last place that we found the unicorn. Over here is where we originally found it. Okay. Shoot unicorn with bow. Hey. Zing bullseye. Okay. No longer afraid of you. It's now your friend. Sick. Okay. We got ourselves a unicorn. I was going to say something about this situation, but I'm not going to. Not going to. Not do you any good, as you could mount the unicorn, but not guide it? What? What? Pet unicorn? I'm not close. I. Seems as if you've made a friend, Rosella. Okay, well, great. Sorry, unicorn, but you're now gonna. Well, shit. What? Lead unicorn? Oh, we need a fucking bridle. Oh, god damn it. Okay. What is with King's Quest and bridles? Christ. Okay. I haven't seen a bridle anywhere. You don't have it. Oh my god. Maybe Lelote has one. Yeah, if only we had a snake handy. Oh my god. Well, we haven't searched the. So I'm just thinking here. Were there any screens where a bridal would possibly be on? So there's the fisherman's house on the pier. Maybe there. Pool. So there's the giant's house. Maybe there's a bridal at the giant's house. Perhaps. I don't think that the. So here's the mine. And the treehouse. I don't think the treehouse would have a bridal. It is close by. I guess I could check, but So there's also the ocean area that we haven't explored at all. And apparently there's an island that has something, I guess. But God, maybe in that in this square, in the that one square we haven't been to yet up here, maybe the bridal is there. Or maybe the bridal was that that line of pixels that I saw next to the creepy tree. Alright, hold on. Let me load this and see if that's. Oh, not that one. This one. Is there a bridal here? Okay. Of course not. That would be too easy. Well, I don't think we tried crossing the bridge yet up here. Like, maybe there's just a bridal here. We don't have it. Of course not. Maybe the fisherman just randomly has a bridal. We walk through this pond. Yeah. All right. So to the left is where the minstrel is. Where am I? Hello? Where am I? Okay. So to the left is just a beach. Oh, he just comes over here. Sure. All right, is there a bridle here? We don't have it. Sure. Alright, she's kneading over there. Alright, so they were mad because they got nothing. So maybe they want the pouch of diamonds, because they were mad about being poor earlier. And just like the King's Quest 1, I think, we found that bowl of infinite porridge and gave it to the poor husband and wife, and then they ate it, but then didn't know it was infinite. Maybe it's a similar thing here, because, you know, Roberta wrote it. This original story, do not steal. Okay, so what if we give pouch? Oh, not close enough, okay. Give pouch. Offer the pouch of diamonds to the fisherman, takes it gladly. Wife, give the girl my fishing pole in trade. Alright, so we traded a bunch of diamonds for a fishing pole. Okay. You wouldn't happen to have a bridle here, would you? Get bridle. Take a different approach. Okay. So, sure. Alright, so we got a fishing pole. Okay. Yep, that's fishing pole. Or, all right, I guess we're going fishing. Maybe we can hook the fishing line onto the unicorn and use that to just... It's practically the same thing. Or we can hook it like that on it and... Probably not, because Roberta Williams. Use fishing pole. Fish with pole. That is not clear. Fish. Of course, fish is the clearest way to put that. Because fish could be a noun, a verb. Sure. Sure thing, Roberta. But wait, you haven't baited your hook. Oh my god. What the hell are we gonna... Oh, our worm. Oh, that's what the worm... Okay. Use worm on pole. And this must be what the bait command is for. Bait. Hook with worm. Gingerly bait the hook of fishing worm. Okay. Sure. And now we fish. Fling the baited line. All right. We're a master baiter now. Almost immediately, you feel a sharp tug on the line. It pulls and fights your line. A fine fat fish. Okay. So we got a fat fish. Sure. Oh, it's a dead fish. Okay, they're very clear that it is a dead fish this time. Okay. Interesting. Because I was going to talk to the fish, but this one is clearly dead. Okay. All right. So what happens if we... How many screens can we go here before the game kills us? Yeah, of course you need the stink lines for the dead fish. That's how you know it's a dead fish. Okay. There's a whale here. I don't know if that's serves any sort of... Oh. I see. That was on this screen. All right. Original story, do not steal. Okay. So it looks like we got a floating bottle, and we got a skeleton. Not close enough. Hopefully we can get out of here. Okay. Skeleton. We'll call him James. Sure. Horrors, you've been swallowed by a huge whale. Okay. Alright, glass bottle with something inside. Open bottle. Retrieve the imprisoned note. Read note. Thanks, Ken. Okay, can we go further inside the whale here? That can. Moving and shaking. So what was the purpose of this? Just to get the bottle, I guess? Like, I assume we still have the bottle. Yeah, okay, so the glass bottle and the note. Yeah, that can. Okay, so now what? We have to tickle the... Okay, we spent too long in here, apparently. Oh, we gotta be disappointed by Roberta first. There we go. Alright. Okay. Oh, huh. So is there... Like right here, and then tickle uvula. With what? With what? The dead fish? The shovel? I think I think this is a soft lock. Or this is dead man walking right now. Like maybe the fishing pole? Okay. So clearly we need a feather or something. Yeah, because we're supposed to tickle that, but I don't think we have what we need to get out of this situation. Okay, so I suppose we can't do that now. Okay, can we go south of here without the whale spawning? Alright, so there's more fish. There's the whale again. So it looks like the whale can just appear on... kind of any screen. Okay. So then it should wrap around here back to the top. Getting very tired. Okay. Well, let's see what the drowning death looks like. Too tired to swim. Join Davy Jones in his locker. All right. Thanks, Roberta. Okay. All right, so clearly we can't do anything else there until we get the feather. Like, maybe... Maybe the unicorn, unicorn's got wings, right? And perhaps that, God, how are we even going to get there? All right, so that's north two screens. Maybe we can get a feather from the unicorn now that it's not running away from us. Oh. So this is Pan, I guess. So where is this? This is the flowers screen. All right, so this is Pan. Is a random encounter. He's too wrapped up in his flute music. Okay. So if we had a lute, perhaps, then maybe we could get that flute from him. Maybe he wants a dead fish. Give fish to Pan. Pan would not be interested in your dead fish. Give gold ball to Pan. Pan would not be interested. Give crown to Pan. Can we take flute? You can't. Pan won't give it to you. Okay. Yeah, I have a feeling we probably need the loot in order to do that. And how the hell did we get the loot? Okay. So the screen to the right of here is the pool where we got the Cupid's bow. And then the screen to the north of here should be where the unicorn is, and hopefully is still there. Yep, okay. So can we get a feather? Get unicorn feather. No. Okay. Take the horn. You can't get that. Touch the horn. Stroke horn. Sure. I'm not. We made a friend, but we can't do anything with it. Okay. Mountain path. So there was a screen with pine cones that we haven't really investigated too much. Because reasons. So the screen to the right of here is the giant's house. And screen south of here is just a generic forest screen. So there's pine cones here too. Like, I have a feeling that there's probably some sort of random encounter that happens here. So there's just... Okay, there's Pan again. Okay. So like I suspected, this is another Pan screen. It's just like the minstrel. But... Sure. And then there's still this bird up here jiving. Yep, they just... There's no code in here for that bird to not dance. Alright, so anything... Okay, pine cones are not a thing in this game, apparently. Okay, so the screen to the right of here is a possible giant spawn screen. And the only way I've ever come to this screen was from the north of it. And this is where I got caught by the giant a few times. Oh. Well, he spawned in the lower left, so not much I could have done there. Alright, you got me again, Roberta. Huh. So I'm not sure what the hell we're supposed to do with the giant's house. So we're currently on this screen right here. So the giant's house is to the north and east of us. There's still the creepy trees. I guess I could try getting through the creepy trees again. Like maybe there's a way to safely do that I just haven't stumbled across yet. Okay. Would there happen to be a bridle here? Okay, can we hide? While the giant goes inside the house, maybe? All right, what about looking in the window? Make out no details. Great. just like the first few games. Okay, so if we can... Oh, jeez. Sorry about that. Creepy forest. Yeah, my bad. I forgot I still had it up. It's hard for me to tell sometimes. Okay. So if I can make it to the right part of the screen, we can get to that one map space that I haven't been to yet. Okay, so getting caught there is no good. Can we go north of here? Okay. I have a feeling this is just... You're just not supposed to... Get through this? Best to stay clear of them. Well, I'd like to, but... There's probably a horse bre- Okay. So that one gets you if you get too close to the top of the screen, and then the other one gets you if you're too far to the right, so... Yeah, I don't think we can get through that way either, so there's gotta be some sort of... Some other mechanism... To get through those. Either that, or you have to, like, ride the unicorn to that screen. Because you kind of had to do that in the first couple games. Or you had to ride the eagle in the first game. And then in the second game... Okay. Anything else to say, Raven? Maybe the Raven will drop a feather. Like in King's Quest 3. That walking animation, though, is pretty good. So it looks like they at least randomized the spawns for the giant. You see nothing special. So it isn't like the first two games where they always spawned in the same place all the time. Oh, it's the ogre. Okay. Sure. So the problem we're trying to solve now is we're given the task to get a unicorn and bring it back to Lelote. Maybe we have to go back to Lelote right now and ask for a bridle. Maybe we have to report to her that we got a unicorn, but we don't have a bridle. And maybe she'll give us one. And then that'll solve our problems. I suppose. So what's the best way to do that? So we want to go north from the giant's house back to the mine. Yeah, we do still have another bow. Yeah, that's true. We have one more arrow. I guess it's worth a try. Let's see if we can make... Use bow on ogre. Shoot ogre with bow. Can't do that now. Use Cupid's bow on with ogre. Shoot ogre. Okay. Apparently not. Okay. Let's see. So, north of here is the mine, but we're not going that way. We want to go this way, and we're going to head back to the base of the mountains. And then see if that gives us any progress. Like, maybe that the big creepy house in the cemetery. God. Ask for bridal. Talk to Goon. Must not speak, they only utter. Okay, sure. Oh, they just pick you up and toss you here. Okay. Well, that's clearly not it. Interesting. I wonder what this is. Okay, well, I'm clearly stumped right now, so I'll have to think about this, and I was gonna call it around this time anyway. So we'll call that the end of part.